Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Sakshi Goel. The topic is Counting Significant Figures from section Uncertainty in Measurement. Suppose we measure the length of a piece of paper with a centimeter scale and get a result of 10.4 centimeter. In this, 10 is a certain digit and 4 is uncertain digit. We are not sure about the last digit, and uncertainty in that last digit is plus minus 1. So the result would be written as 10.4 plus minus 0.1 centimeter. An easy method of expressing the uncertainty in a measurement is to express it in terms of significant figures. Significant figures are meaningful digits which are known with certainty. There are some rules to count the number of significant figures in a number. The rules for determining significant figures are: first is, all non-zero digits are significant. We can see in example 175, all are non-zero digits. So there are three significant figures here. Similarly, 1.75 also has three significant figures. Second rule is, zeros between two non-zero digits are significant. For example, in 5031, it has four significant figures. And in 1.402, it also has four significant figures. So the zeros between two non-zero digits are significant. Third rule is, zeros to the left of first non-zero digit are not significant. For example, 0.0083 has two significant figures and 0.005 has one significant figure. So the zeros to the left of first non-zero digit are not significant. Fourth rule is, zeros at the end of a number are further categorized as: zeros after a decimal point are always significant. So 38.0 has three significant figures and 76.530 has five significant figures. So the zeros after a decimal point are always significant. Zeros before a decimal point and after a non-zero number are always significant. For example, in 540.0, it has four significant figures. So all the zeros are counted here. In second example, 350.08 has five significant figures. So the zeros are lying between two non-zero numbers, and we can also see here that the zero is before and after a decimal. Even then, they are counted as significant figures. Last rule is, zeros before an implied decimal point are ambiguous and should be avoided by using scientific notation. For example, 6800 should be written as 6.8 × 10³. So it has two significant figures, and it can also be written as 6.80 × 10³. Again, it has three significant figures. So the same number can be written in two forms having different significant figures. In rounding off, the extra digits are dropped with or without minor changes in the figures retained. One should keep following points in mind while rounding off the numbers. First rule is, if the rightmost digit is to be removed is more than 5, then the preceding number is increased by 1. For example, in 61.48, it is rounded off to 61.5 because the rightmost digit which is to be removed is more than 5, which is 8. So it is more than 5. So the preceding number, which is 4, it is increased by 1. So the number becomes 61.5. Second is, if the rightmost digit is to be removed is less than 5, then the preceding number remains same. For example, in 61.43, it is rounded off to 61.4 because the rightmost digit, which is 3, it is less than 5. So the preceding number, which is 4, it remains same. So the after rounding off, the number becomes 61.4. If the rightmost digit to be removed is 5, then the preceding number remains same if it is an even number. For example, 61.45 is rounded off to 61.4. The rightmost digit, which is 5, then the preceding number, which is 4, it is an even number. So it remains same. So it becomes 61.4. But if the rightmost digit to be removed is 5, then the preceding number is increased by 1 even if it is an odd number. For example, in 61.35, the number to be removed is 5. And the preceding number, which is 3, so it is an odd number. So it is rounded off to 61.4. 3 is increased by 1, so it becomes 4, so 61.4. Significant figures in calculations. The precision of the measured quantities should not be lost while doing mathematical calculations using those quantities. So some rules are to be followed for calculations of significant figures. First rule is, during multiplication or division, the final result will have the same number of significant figures as the quantity with least number of significant figures. For example, for the multiplication of 4.08 into 5.312, the answer comes out to be 21.67296, but it is rounded off as 21.7 because 4.08 has 3 significant figures, 5.312 has 4 significant figures. So the final result will have the same number of significant figures as the quantity with least number of significant figures. So 4.08 has least number of significant figures, that is 3. So that's why the answer will also have 3 significant figures. So it will become 21.7. Now for division, 43.2 divided by 2.317. Here also, the 43.2 has least number of significant figures. That's why the answer is 18.6. In case of addition or subtraction, the final result will have same number of decimal places as the quantity with the fewest decimal places. Here, in example, 1.12 plus 2.2 plus 3.456. First number, 1.12, has 2 decimal places. 2.2 has 1 decimal places. 3.456 has 3 decimal places. So the number with least decimal places is 2.2, that is 1 decimal place. So that's why the answer is 6.8 after rounding off. So similar is the case for the subtraction. Now let's see how much did you understand from this lecture. For this question, time given is 15 seconds. Express the number 4.342 to two significant figures. Hint is you have to round off the number using the rules of rounding off. The time starts now. Answer is 4.3. The rounding off rules apply here. The number has four significant figures. To make it two significant figures, 4 and 2 at the end will be removed and the preceding number is 3. So, and the number which is removed is less than 5. So, the preceding number remains same. So, the answer is 4.3. The question is, mass of wood block is 6.932 gram and volume is 0.90 centimeter cube. What is the density of the block? Express the result to the appropriate significant figures. The hint here is density is equal to mass divided by volume. So the answer here is 7.7 gram per centimeter cube. The solution is density is equal to mass upon volume. Mass is 6.932 gram and volume is 0.90 centimeter cube. So on dividing, the answer comes out to be 7.7022 gram per centimeter cube. But during rounding off, or you can say, as the question asks to express the result to the appropriate significant figures, so 0.90 has two significant figures and 6.932 has four significant figures. So the answer will have the significant figures as same as the number with the least number of significant figures. So the answer will have two significant figures. So the answer is 7.7 gram per centimeter cube.